It's Sunday morning, back at the boat. I think we escaped without any weather last night, so all the masking tape's still stuck to the boat, which is good. Today is hopefully anti-fouling day. Hopefully we can actually get it done today. And I don't know, we've got about a 40% chance of rain as per the forecast, but it's not particularly heavy. There's nothing particularly sinister looking around at the clouds, but it's just a bit overcast. So we're going to take the chance. We're going to do a bit of an anti-fouling job. I'd like to get two coats on, but even one good coat will probably be sufficient because it's only going to be in the water a few months before we take it out again, and we might have to give it a little bit more of a touch-up when we get to that. I think initially I'm just going to do the bits I can reach with the roller that don't require me to get underneath the boat. So I'm quite comfortable to do that probably without putting additional face and respirator protection. But later on, I'm gonna have to mask up and get into some of the real dirty places. Not particularly looking forward to it, but it comes with the territory. Still got plenty of cutting in to do around some of the trickier sections up the front of the cradle where the boat is. There's a few other sliders that I've got to get around. I've got a brush for that. That's going to take a little bit of an effort, but well, no time like the present. Let's just get going. This is officially the most expensive paint I've ever bought in my life. Welcome to boating. $279 for this 4-litre can of semi-ablative hull paint. It's a lot of money for paint that's designed to actually essentially come off the boat so nothing can grow on it. So we are going to give it a little stir. It is black. We did actually look at doing the hull below the waterline in a green paint, but it wasn't in stock. So then we looked at something close. So we looked like an aqua paint, but it was too close to being blue. In the end, I said, look, you know what? Let's go for something safe. The hull is at this stage black, albeit with a kind of very, very slight bluish tinge. And let's just keep to what we know.
But he's got to get underneath yet. I guess if there's one advantage of having a bad back, is you can't get on the ground to faint. It's a thankless job, but someone's got to do it. Hey, Daryl's got to do it.
That's one coat of paint, actually. Two coats with some of the areas are going to get more wear, but getting under that hole is a pain. I'm going to put it in the cradle next time.
There's still some bits I can't get to, but for a few months that's going to be okay. There's two sets of this, so there's the first lot. There is another piece of tape.
Oh, close to the line, I'm not seeing like that, Daryl.
No, no, that's another piece of tape.
I know. You still got to the top of it then.
Yeah, but that's because this tape was there. So it was never in any danger. That's why I put two pieces of tape on.
No, I don't know.
Second, weren't we?
Bit of cleanup to do.
Yeah.
Just really. A little bit.
Oh, most of that was already there.
Was it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Bit there.
At least you can still see the red line.
Yeah, well, that's it. And underneath it, that was all there.
Was it really as bad as that?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's not new. Oh, that cutting is pretty good. Mm. Except for those one or two little spots.
She has her new knickers.
Got black knickers.
I think some of that might need a bit cleaning up though. Some of it's on a bit stodgy, Gowl.
Yeah.
There's a bit of roller, I think. So the idea of this paint is it actually does come off, right?
Yes.
With a build-up of whatever wants to try and live on it. Oh well, that means he's going out next weekend.
Just doing a bit of polishing, and maybe a bit of waxing to finish off the day. Probably a little bit hard to tell because the sun is getting lower in the sky. It's behind some clouds at the moment. I have polished about up to there. From there, further back, it's a bit duller. Maybe, don't know if you can quite see it. Anyway, we're gonna do a bit more polishing at this point and might do a bit of waxing and see how well we can bring it up. Bit of polish. And or rubbing compound, whatever you want to call it. Let's do this bit here. Just under the old name of the boat. We are going to do a name changing ceremony in the not too distant future. So watch out for that one. Sailors being the superstitious type, there is a process. All right, so we're just giving that a little bit of a rub. What we'll do then is we'll buff it out and then we'll attack it with some wax and see how we go with that. So that's polish. This is just cleaning it off. Already you can see a pretty big difference, but I think it's going to be a lot better when we actually put some wax on it. Right, that's polish. That's the unpolished. Let's see how we go with some wax. Let's do this bit. This is wax. That's nice. You can just feel, it just feels smoother. Something very satisfying about doing this. All right, then we buff it off. Should have that almost wet look to it. I wish that if I had a decent sports car or something, I'd be doing this all the time. Don't have a sports car, but I do have a boat now. There we go. That's quite nice.